All right, I hope you have some time. Pull up a chair and welcome to the video. I'm doing a lot of recording right now, and that's necessary because we can't allow the world to get ahead of us at this time. We have to stay ahead of what is really taking place here. And also, I'm having these tremendous breakthroughs and understandings. So I'm pushing the pace, you know, putting on a finishing kick here. And so I just hope that people can accept that there's a lot of information coming out now. And this video's no different. It certainly is going to have some information which is amazing, to say the very least. I've talked about in the last several videos about a new paradigm shift, about how to view the situation that we're in. And it's basically, in a nutshell, it's we are spirit, an idea in the mind of God. Okay, we create like spirit as ideas in the one mind too. We extend God's creation. Now we had this crazy whimsical idea, like, hey, let's see if we can be prime creator. Let's see if we can make our own creation. And so we forgot to just laugh this thing away as silly. And so we're trying to do that. We're trying to create a separate creation, actually. And the way that we're doing that is very somewhat absurd. Very absurd, let's call it. Very absurd. We are trying to create that which doesn't know its creator, which is impossible. It's totally impossible. It's an absurdity. And yet we think we have a way, we know a way to do it, with just to fashion this incredible mirage of time and space and form and change and make it all seem utterly unlike reality. And we believe that once we fashion this mirage that is like a massive history of denial and forgetfulness of reality, that somehow automatically creation will happen within that forgetfulness, and we will have created a new creation that has no idea what created it and thinks that it came from all this time and space and history and the past. It's like a product of the past. And so we are engaged in this effort to an unbelievable extent, and in so doing we have duped ourselves. We've forgotten what we are, actually, and we all are engaged in many roles in trying to make this whole thing work. One of them is we test out the defenses of this, because we don't want any truth getting to our creation, the new creation that we think is going to happen. We want to make sure there's no way it can ever know where it really came from. This is our absurd idea of what the new creation will be like. And so we have efforts to bring the truth into the world, and then we have those who make the efforts to prevent it from really being effective here in the world, and finding ways to twist it, distort it. So you look at history, you have a lot of teachings come to the world, they get twisted, they get distorted, they get forgotten, pushed aside, an idol is made of it, you know, we continuously are testing out the defenses, like, hey, what if this truth came into the world, then how would we distort it so our separate creation would not understand the truth about the situation, actually understand what's really going on, that it's, you know, it's absurd. It's all totally absurd, and yet we're all taking it extremely seriously. So what is the remedy for all of this? And there is a remedy, and I see what the remedy is. Before we talk about that, let us say that we all are kind of scripting this whole thing. Like a movie, we're scripting, we're working on this, we're working on that. We have all these agreements that are testing out, evaluating this mirage and the defense of the mirage. Everything is in this time and space is part of this mirage. It's all part of the mirage, everything. Atoms, molecules, all energy, all form, all fragments, everything, the whole dance, the whole change, location, time, space, location, all of this. It's all part of this mirage. Now, the mirage is something that we are imagining in the mind, in the one mind. It's not separate from the one mind. Nothing is separate from the one mind. Everything has the same being in the one mind. Everything all has one being, the same one being. It's all in the same place. It's in omnipresence, the one mind, the omnipresence, the everywhereness. It's all the same place. In relationship to everywhereness, to endlessness, everything is actually in the exact same place. It's all totally centered in that. All totally centered in that. That's called being. The being. Eternally centered. Totally supported. Eternal support. Can't be otherwise than that. This is the reality. This is reality. But we are overlooking this because we want our offspring, our separate creation, to feel that it is separate from that being. It doesn't have being. It has relative being. Being relative to other beings, to other forms. We're trying to fashion a new creation. New creation, okay? Now, it's not for us, actually. It's not for us. It's trying to confirm that we're prime creators by the reflection we get back from our child that we believe is going to be born into it. And reflecting back, the child say, I believe this and this and this. And they'll say, you see, it has no idea about truth. It has no idea what created it. I've been able to fashion a new life, a new creation. And I'm the God of this new creation. And my child is reflecting back my effectiveness, my power. And we're hoping for that. We're hoping for that. So we continue on with our roles, trying to fashion this mirage of the past. To dupe, to deceive. And we believe that once we succeed, the child will be born and it will reflect back to us. It has no idea about truth or reality or what created it. And we will say, you see, we're prime creator. And then we feel we'll be happy and all problems solved. And everything will be perfect for us. One of the problems with that, of course, is that there is no child. There is no creation, separate creation. It will never happen. That's a big problem, right? That's a big problem. So if we can stop right at that problem, it's never going to happen. So what do we do with this mirage is the question. What do we do with all these roles? We're so caught up in functioning the way we've been functioning, working on the mirage, that we feel it's impossible to get free of it. Well, there is a way to get free, and we'll introduce it here. I've talked about it many, many times, but I'm going to make it a little more clear here. I say we're all our script, we're in a role. We have a role scripted for us. Everyone is functioning to try and produce this mirage of an ignorant past, a past that has no idea of where it came from and is utterly unlike reality and stuff. So we're all working on that, everything. Now, what we have the power to do, each one of us, is for one moment, is to allow everything in the entire universe of our imagination to go off script for just a moment. Everything at the same time, concurrently. I've said in a previous video way back, now is concurrent with time. It's very important, the concurrency. At the exact same moment, every bit of this imagined mirage, all the energy, the atoms, the particles, the activity, everything goes off script together. The whole thing off script. And just imagine intuitively, just feel intuitively this idea of allowing everything to go off script together. Now, what I realized today is the capacity for us to do this. We could have a capacity to do this. We don't have to hold our imagination to the script. We can allow everything to go off script together. And as such, it's all still, it's not like one part is on script and the other's not on script, so it's all chaotic that way. No, everything goes off script together. It takes a break from the script, just a total break. Just go off script, everything go off script. No longer doing the script that you think you need to do. Everything off script together. What could be seen there? Being could be seen, could be experienced. Because all of this is a rejection of being, present being here now. It's all an attempt to say that being is the result of a process in time and space. Which is not true. It's just not true. So everything, allow everything to go off script. You know, an actor is reading lines and suddenly the actor decides to just go off script. And the other actors or actress says, well, wait a minute. Why, this is not in the script, you know, and they like, but let's say they both went off script together. And the audience went off script with them. And the whole world went off script with them. And the whole universe went off script with them. Everything went off script. All our imagination went off script together at the same time. Same exact instant. Same instant. Everything off script. And I feel that we can do this. I feel that we have the capacity to allow this to happen, to go off script. Everything. Now, it may be that going off script is simply a simple shift in our willingness to see being, you know, within us. And so our perception, when our perception shifts, everything goes off script. The entire universe goes off script. But we can look at it externally as if we allow everything to go off script. We can look at both ways. We allow ourselves to go off script. We allow the entire universe to go off script. It's all off script suddenly. Everything's off script. And then you just see the beingness of everything now. The beingness is there. And you realize beingness is not the result of any process of time and space at all. And then you know that time and space can do nothing to what you are, the oneness, can do nothing to it. Now, I see some practical applications to this also, actually, very much so. The ability to just go off script like that, just let everything just go off script, right distance of everything, could very well enable you to shift dimensions. It could very well enable you to immediately find yourself in a different place, different dwelling place. It could actually open up just the range of infinite miracles, actually, because you allow everything at any moment to simply go off script, this whole realm of our imagination, everything off script right now. And then you can pick up whatever script you want, any place, anywhere, etc. You know, it opens the door, but we're not really aiming for that. But it could be a side benefit to that, as this world, today I asked again, what's going to happen in this world? And the answer I got was just terrible. As I don't know what to say, havoc, disaster, catastrophe, sudden, you know, overwhelming cataclysm. Well, maybe, maybe not. It's certainly, this is a reoccurring theme in many people's seeing of the future of this planet, is the end times problems. At what time it would be very helpful to know, to be able to shift dimensions like that, you know, just like that, just, and this would be very easy, actually, for us, very easy. Simply, you allow everything to go off script, boom, all off script right now. Because keep in mind that this entire mirage of time and space has actually no purpose to it whatsoever. Because there isn't any going to be any creation of time and space. We're not going to be able to create a child of time and space, a real child. It's all still just imagination. So it really serves no purpose at all. So there's no reason why you cannot just let it all go off script for a moment. Doesn't harm what you are at all. Doesn't interfere with your purpose at all. Because it has no purpose. we made it all, we fashioned it all to serve the purpose of deceiving the creation that we thought we could create. But we cannot create a separate creation with a separate will that can be deceived. It's impossible. So there'll never be such a birth. So it's useless. The mirage of time and space is totally useless to us. So why not then use it to experience going off script? you can use it that way, right? Just use it and say, okay, everything right now, entire universe, off script. All off script. Just be still. Being still is off script, isn't it? As it is. There's no part of the script we've been working on which is just stillness, which is just doing nothing, just stopping everything. Full stop. You can say full stop also, but off script. I like the off script. You know, just go off script. Let everything go off script. Like that. So, this is, I feel intuitively this is what we need to hear. This is the one. It fits in with everything I've studied, everything I've paid attention to. It fits in with the full stop, with the vision of oneness. It fits in with everything. Let everything go off script. Don't hold anything to the script that has been written, that we have written for it. Don't hold anything to the script. Be okay that everything goes off script. Now, another benefit of this is that no matter where you are, who you are, what your habits are, what your role is, and everybody has them, and some will like your role and some won't like your role at all. That's the way it is here. You can have everything go off script, including your script too, the whole universe off script. And you will feel this being, this oneness, the stillness, the peace beyond understanding. It's all, you can do it. Nobody can stop you from doing that. And of course, you look at the world and you see the scripts that are written and that people are playing, and you know, they're terrible scripts. I mean, it's all bad. I mean, we're all engaged in this deception. But some will be your friends and some will be your enemies. Some will be the ones that are helping you and some are the ones that you're targeting or you're hindering or whatever. It's all, you know, and we all have these really lousy roles, really. None of the roles here in this world reflect what we are in the slightest bit. None of the roles. But that's why I say, let everything go off script. Don't hold anyone to any role whatsoever. Don't hold even any atom to any role. Any microorganism, any body, any person, any thought, any personality. Don't hold anything to any role, to any valuing, is another way to put it. Don't hold anything to any role whatsoever. Give up the freedom, all the freedom to go off script right now. And then no matter what role you have been playing, you will experience your freedom from all roles. You will realize that roles are unnecessary. That being, the one relationship, is always here now. And that being is always here now, without exception. So this is a cure-all. It is a cure-all. Allow everything to go off script. It's a cure-all. Now, even though there are many, many whose purpose is to prevent this for anyone from going off script, and they're very, you know, quick to catch, you know, oh, you're going off script. No, what do you call those? Experts in maintaining your continuity with the script, right? Maintaining continuity with your script. In movies, they have the continuity person who very carefully, you know, studies all the continuity of the movie. There's also, you know, continuity of the script, making sure that the script is followed. And so you do have those in the world who are like that. Absolutely. A lot. And that's a role too, and those who do that can drop that, can allow everything to go off script, everything at the same time. So it's not like somebody's going off script and there's someone else that needs to be on script. You're allowing everything, all roles, to go off script. You're not holding anything to any script whatsoever. Everything, the being is there, no matter what process or script or whatever anyone's doing. It doesn't matter. The being is there. But as long as we are seeing that the script, following a script, is what's going to establish a new creation, you know, we'll freak out and say, no, you got to stay on script. How can we have a new creation? How can I ever be happy and have that reflected to me that I'm prime creator unless we get the child to be born? And we got to stay on script to get the child to be born. It's all scripted. It shall be, a child shall be born once the script has been followed perfectly. And we imagine there's a God telling us this, that once the script is followed perfectly, the child shall be born. You know, we've made all this up. This is a make-believe. I'm going to go off script right now, as a matter of fact. I don't have a script, but I'm going to even go off that, and I'm going to crack open a nice A&W root beer, diet root beer. But allowing everything to go off script is a very profound experience. I'm not suggesting that anyone behave in a kooky, spontaneous way and take their clothes off and go running downtown, woohoo, you know, and doing cartwheels and chugging beer and whatever, you know. No. I'm not suggesting anything like that. I'm suggesting you quietly experience the awesome profundity of allowing everything to go off script together. Quiet sitting. This is realized probably best in quiet sitting. Or perhaps you're walking, or perhaps you're driving. Set everyone free from all scripts. Set ourselves free from all scripts. Set the oneself free from all scripts. Absolutely. So I do hope this is a remedy that people can relate to. No matter what your script has been, we've all been engaged in so many different roles. It doesn't matter what your role is. It makes no difference. Because you're setting everyone free from all roles, everything free from all roles. It doesn't matter what your role is then, right? Because together, you're dropping it all together. Everyone, the whole universe, all roles, at the exact same moment are dropped together. Just imagine that. Where's the guilt? Where's the awkward? Nothing. No, you just, the release and the relief is there. A blessed relief will be there for you. So I do hope I can do this and others can do it. Because we have to have some hope that there's a way to back away from this abyss that we are headed to as a world, really. Because the world, again, we're trying to get this child born so we can be happy. We think we'll be happy as a child has no idea where it came from. You'll see, aha, we did it. And as the child seems to be totally protected from ever knowing, anyone ever informing it of the truth, we'd like to make a world where truth is outlawed, entirely outlawed. That's what they're going towards now. Very much so. You know, they're starting out small potatoes and this and that, but gradually the momentum is building to say that everyone must profess a certain doctrine which has no truth to it whatsoever. And we want some sort of uniformity of that. We're going towards that. everyone's sort of agreeing, okay, let's all agree. And then we feel once this happens, somehow the child will be born, it will reflect what we want to reflect back to us, and we'll say, ah, you see, we succeeded, we are now prime creator, we are now happy. Just magically, all like this. We have this whole magical belief this is all going to happen this way. It will never happen that way. Not even remotely ever happen that way. But we're also trying to make the world have a history of such a terrible history. We want the child to think that life comes out of catastrophe and death and suffering and misery that is born from that. So after a horrendous cataclysm and catastrophe, we have a golden age now where we feel this is what gave birth to us. These are the labor pains that gave birth to us. Again, a way to completely have no inkling of reality whatsoever. So we're headed pell-mell into such a situation. Now, there are those who are trying to hold things together. I don't know how it's going to play out exactly in the world, but we are definitely headed into a very tense situation. The sensitives I know are shaking. They're trembling. They're shaking. They feel that there's this, you know, super instability coming, stumbling, falling down. You know, just like, wow, there's really this intensity is felt. I'm also shaking, and I can feel I'm exhausted. It's a tremendous intensity coming now. So some people have said a pole tilt, axle tilt, you know, of the earth, which is a possibility. The earth's wobble is a possibility that it could, if it wobbles enough, it could happen. Who knows what's going to happen? There have been a lot of conjecture from the doom and gloom prophets. And who knows? But I wouldn't count anything out, actually. Wouldn't count anything out. So we need rock steady peace of mind. We have to be able to let everything go off script, the entirety of it all off script right now. Full, the Don Dulles, full stop right now, full stop. Off script right now. Everything off script right now. Everything off script right now. Just consider that. Everything off script right now. Because nothing has to remain on script at all in existence, really. But it's better if we all go off script together, right? All off script together. And we can see that in our own perception by our willingness to see it. It's kind of like you put, you know, glasses on or sunglasses, whatever. You see everything. Everything is no longer the scripted way you're used to seeing. You say, ah, everything looks different. Everything off script. You're willing to see everything off script. You see the being of everything. And that's certainly off script, isn't it? Because the whole thing is scripted to be producing being, or really non-being. It really has to do with trying to make an eternal non-being and call that life. That's what we're trying to do. Trying to script an eternal non-being and then believe it's life and say, look what we did. We're greater than God. We created non-being, eternal non-being. It's all absolutely absurd, so you have to have some humor about it, but this is what we're trying to do. Everything off script right now. Everything off script right now. And just relax into that. Just relax into that. Easy, right? Just relax into it. Just say, okay, I'm going to allow everything concurrently, the same time, to go off script this very instant. I'm going to allow that to happen. I'm going to see everything as off script. Now, you may be one of those who are one of those people who want to keep everyone on script, but you're tired of doing that. You're tired of doing it. You're tired of pumping yourself up, trying to stay energized to do this. You're tired of you know, because you got to be so vigilant, right? And you have to appear to be so right and correct and vigilant. Everyone's got to be on script. And you may say, okay, I'm through with that. I'm through with it. So I'm going to allow everything to go off script right now. Huge relief. Huge relief. Huge relief. Because again, in this world, there are roles of every variety, you know. So I sound like I can talk to one role and not another and something. Because I mean, some roles I like, some like roles I don't. We're all the same way. Because some roles are trying to keep everybody on script, and some are saying, "Well, a little bit of unscriptedness is okay. So let's have a little bit of unscriptedness." But that's all the same, really. Because what we need to do is allow everything to go off script at the same time. And then we see being. We see the being there and say, ah, everyone is saved. Everything is saved. We're all saved. Together, we're all saved. It's not like someone reached being and then someone else is going to reach being. No, we see everyone reaches being together. Everyone is aware, you know, we're aware that all is being at the same time. Well, it's always been that. But our awareness of it is that it's all happens at the exact same moment. Everything equally sacred. Everything equally sacred. There's nothing that reached being first or reached being second or third or whatever, because everything's always been in being. There is no being is timeless. Timeless. Everything off script right now. I allow everything to go off script right now. So this is a very practical step we have to take now, and it's necessary as we are, you know, the saber rattling, the whole world is getting very weird, right? In my opinion, things are going to be totally messed up from what I see. The way the script is going is going to be a total mess up, total screw up here. Really a total screw up. And that's our gift to our child that we think we're going to have. You know, it's like, this is our gift. You'll never be able to believe about reality now. No matter what anyone says, you'll never believe it. Look how screwed up everything is. Look, you're the child, an eternal non-being, you see, and then how could you have being with all this total screw-up, you know? But it's within our power again to get everything off script right now. Always. We have that power always. Just think of that. We always have this power within us. Everything off script right now. I allow everything to go off script right in this instant. We have the power. Once we start exercising that power, then we will start realizing our freedom, our true freedom. And then we'll know we're really saved. We are truly saved. Never again will we ever think we're trapped in any roles. Without that, anything is ever trapped in a role. There's no possibility of being trapped in a role at all, actually. And we'll never see it that way again. Never. But we have to exercise this. We have to practice this. So we'll see what happens. I certainly need a job, actually, at this point. I don't have a job, really, that's sustaining me. And so I don't know what kind of job I'm going to get. But hopefully I can have some sort of job where I help people go off script, you know, not people, but help people allow everything to go off script. You know, that's what cures. Allow everything to go off script. It's not like I'm allowing you to go off script, you're allowing me. No, everything go off script together is the only way. It's the only way. Let's let everything go off script right now. Everything. The sun, the moon, the stars, the galaxy, the universe. energy, matter, form, physics, gravity, the entirety of everything off script together. Not doing anything. You see, if everything's off script, how can anything be harmed? Because, you know, we're subject to gravity. Gravity goes off script, but we're off script too. Everything's off script. So there isn't any there aren't any forces, there aren't any dynamics, there isn't anything that needs anything. That's all scripted. It's all scripted, but we're going off script altogether. We realize just, you know, beingness, pure beingness, which doesn't require a script. It's not scripted. That's God's script, as it were, the prime creator script. Pure beingness. So we're getting this into the psyche here of this of the one mind here that is have these roles scripted to be in this world at this time. You see, we're getting that into the psyche just in time before before certain things happen in the world. So we know the answer. Know the answer. Where we are, and another thing is it helps your security, you know, feel like secure, because no, whatever's happening, if you know something, like something, you just say, let everything go off script right now. And I feel it is miraculous. Because whatever's happening to you, it's scripted. You're part of the script. You're agreeing to the script. But if you say, let everything go off script right now, it's a complete reset, right? And you're no longer part of that script. That script is not happening anymore. So if you find that there's some script that you don't like, you can say, let everything go off script, and accept that from the, you know, from the very heart of your acceptance, total acceptance of it. And somehow that's going to reset everything for you. I don't know exactly how, but I feel that without too much practice, people will actually learn how to do that and experience tremendous freedom, even within this dream, leading to remembrance of ultimate freedom. That's why Jesus could walk on water, everything off script, you know, and then just re-scripted it to do that, you know, everything off script. There's something to do with allowing everything to go off script. A willingness for it. And then if something, you know, joins with that, perhaps, then there's a raising from the dead or something like that. But all that stuff, for me, it's very beside the point. It's just ancillary stuff. It comes in the wake of what's really important, really. It's like a big boat, there's a wake back there. Oh, well, okay, so there's a wake. Whatever. Now, what's important is the being, is we experience the being. The absolute present being of all. One total relationship that all has with all. The one total support that all has with all. The total oneness. To experience that, that's what's important. The other stuff, it's not even worth a penny, really. I mean, it's just, don't even pay a penny for it, really. But if it comes along for the ride, you know, whatever, fine. But peanuts, as we call them, just peanuts. Don't be, you know, concerned about that. Whatever. For me, I try to just be oblivious to all that stuff. You know, all the the psychic, you know, all the psychic powers, the miracles that are done, you know, this, I could absolutely care less. What a waste of time for me to, nothing for me. Absolutely nothing. If someone raised the dead up, still, I would, for me, it'd be nothing. I could care less. All those physical miracles, though, I could absolutely care less. It's just no different than anything else. It doesn't even, you know, fill my sails to the slightest bit. It's not healing. It doesn't solve our problem in the slightest bit, really. And it might get us all intrigued about, you know, wasting time about trying to figure out something. So, all of that stuff is just the easiest pie once you are able to release everything from all roles simultaneously. Let everyone go off script. Let everything go off script. Yeah. Then from that point, everything is a piece of cake. So what's the big deal? There's no big deal about it. Don't even worry about it. Well, well, the big deal is to let everything go off script. That's the big deal. Because then experiencing the oneness is the big deal. That is the big deal for sure. And the gratitude that we realize we're all one family. And by we, I don't mean human bodies. I mean spirit. Spirit, we're all, there's only one family. Let's put it that way. There's only one family and we are it. And there's only one family and everything is it. There's only one family, and everything is it. We are that family. Just noticed a caterpillar on the flower. Looks like a leaf, or looks like a part of the greenery of the flower. No, it's a caterpillar. I'll let it be. I won't show it to you because I could. Maybe not. It's a superfluous detail. We're more concerned about let everything go off script right now. Let the caterpillar go off script. Let the flower go off script. Let the glass go off script. Let the table go off script. Let that plant go off script. Let the light go off script. Let these flowers go off script. Let the vase go off script. Let the background go off script. Let the camera go off script. Let this area go off script. Let this universe go off script. Let the world go off script. Let the total world, let the entire world, I give the entire world permission to go off script right now. So we give it permission. I give the entire universe permission to go off script right now. I give permission for these flowers to go off script right now. I give permission for this table to go off script right now. I give permission for this house to go off script right now. I give permission for that walkway to go off script right now. I give permission for those cars to go off script right now. I give permission for that party to go off script right now. I give permission to the whole country to go off script right now. I give permission for the whole world to go off script right now. I give permission to the entire universe to go off script right now. Just practice, but the goal is everything at the same moment. I give permission for everything to go off script right now. Everything without exception. I give permission for everything without exception to go off script right now. I give permission for everything as it is, without any exception, to go off script right now. This is a potent, 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 potent practice. Maybe some people need help with this. Possible. I certainly need something to do with my time. And, you know, so I don't know what's going to happen. I really don't know. With my life, I don't know. I don't know. It's again, the cars are ready to go over the cliff. And I don't want to go over the cliff, that's for sure. So I better have something that I can offer value to the world for sure. Yeah, I certainly feel I have something of value to offer. I have certain capacity. I can consider ideas and teachings and stuff without really getting too rattled by it. And when I do get rattled by it, I'm not really rattled by that. And that's the important part. If I'm reading something from a great teacher, and that's what I read. I read a few right now. I'm reading just a little bit here and there from really the, you know, greatest teachers. And sometimes I don't agree. Sometimes I say, I don't like the style of that. Or sometimes I say, why did you emphasize that? Or it's like, And I get a little bit rattled by it, and like it, I get, throw the book away. I'm gonna throw it away, put it on the shelf. I don't want to read that anymore. And then later on, I'll say, whatever. Let me read something else. I'm not gonna, if he says something, I don't like, whatever. Let me read this. Okay, I like that. Oh, this is really good. Okay. And some I like and some I don't like as much, and that's okay. It's all okay. It's all okay. So I don't get rattled by getting rattled. I don't get rattled very much, and when I do, I don't get rattled for getting rattled. And that's just from a long effort. Extremely continuous, long effort. So if someone says something I don't agree with or something, I just let's go on with something else. Maybe there's something else they'll say I like. So I'll look for that, you know, and just like that, do like that. Or I'll say, there you go again, talking like that. Oh man, you know. But they say, you know, probably it's the style, it's language, it's, you know, I give them the benefit of the doubt that whatever it is that they're trying, you can't please everybody. You can't please everybody. I'm looking at it through my role too, right? My script and everything. So you cannot please everybody with everything you say. You cannot. So you just have to let it slide by. Let it slide by. I'm not going to worry about that. And I get permission for everything to go off script right now. So that nobody has to get anything. We're all off script. There's nothing we need to get. So it's the instant cure of everything, really. So nothing really matters. It doesn't really matter if we can give everything permission to go off script this very instant. We're cured. We are cured. That's it. We are cured because we are seeing the oneness. We are experiencing the being, the oneness. We're experiencing it. That's the cure. That is the cure, plain and simple. There is no other cure. That is the cure. So if we have the cure, nothing else matters. Nothing else matters. Whether you're comfortable with the style or not, it doesn't matter anymore. So basically, don't let anything slow you down. If you read something from a great teacher and you say, don't let it slow you down. Don't let anything slow you down. Just get to the point where you can say, I give permission for everything to go off script right now. Everything. Everyone, everything. Total permission. The people that have roles you hate the most, give them permission too, right? Why not? You hate their role anyway. So wouldn't it be great if they were off script too? And those people you like, do you really like them so much that you want them to keep the script? No, nobody likes any role or script that much. No. Not even the teachers. I give permission to all the great teachers to go off script too, because I don't even like them enough to keep them on their script either. Because it's all words, it's all concepts, it's all roles, it's all scripts. Let's everything. I give permission for everything to go off script right now, including the great sages, the great teachers, you know. And they're great because they gave permission for everyone to go off script too. That's what they've done. So don't hold them to a script either. Let them go off script too. spirit thinks big, you know, spirit thinks big, and so we, it's a chuckle, because so whoever you are, whatever your role is, whatever your script, allow everyone to go off script, including anybody who's advising you or helping you. Extend that to me too, to everyone. It's okay. Everyone together, all together as one, all off script. All off script together. Now that's an idea that spirit likes. You know, when this idea came to me, I said, I like that. I love it. My spirit reacted to it like, wow, yes, that's great. None of this other nonsense. I hate this, all this piecemeal stuff. I just can't. That's for the intellect. That's for the consciousness. That's for mind. That's for to consider, to analyze. I said, forget that. Let's all go off script together. Everything off script together right now. Everything off script right now. Now that is what spirit likes. Spirit relates to that. All inclusive, total, this instant, you know, this. Is this complete totality, abstraction. That is music to spirit's ears, you know. That's the music spirit dances to. Everything. I give permission for everything to go off script right now, this instant. This instant. I give permission for everything as it is, without any exception whatsoever, to go off script right now, this instant. Now you may think the caterpillar will drop from the flower, but the flower is going off script too. And gravity is going off script too. Right? So actually, it may be that actually nothing happens as far as the structure of anything, right? Because everything's off script together. So the caterpillar won't necessarily suddenly drop off the flower. Because the flower and the caterpillar will drop together. And the whole world will drop together, and the whole universe will drop together. It'll all drop off script together. This is very nice. And what will be revealed in that dropping, all dropping together? Being, oneness will be revealed, will stand revealed. The curtain drops. And since everything is still fine, functioning fine, we won't need anything to go back on script, will we? No. All off script together. So. Just soak this up intuitively. Don't try to understand it intellectually. Jesus says when you're responding to something without intellect, without emotion, without the consciousness trying to get involved in it and all this, but you're still feeling that you're experiencing without any of that judgment or anything, he says that you're experiencing the light. He calls it the light. And he says that the light, true light, the light, electromagnetic light, radiation from electromagnetism, has absolutely nothing to do with the true light, really. Although, he says that actually it's actually everything is made of light, the true light, even electromagnetism stuff, but it's like a frozen, imprisoned, it's like the true light almost frozen in prison. It's the densest of the true light, and so for all intents and purposes it is not the true light at all. Not really talking about that, no. But we can see the true light within us, and it's this recognition within us that does not coming from our intellect. You see, something like I give permission for everything as it is to go off script this instant. There's something that responds to that, but it's not our psyche, our human psyche, or anything like that. No. It's the light within us that's responding to that, I believe. And so just get used to that light within you responding. Again, it's not electromagnetic radiation we're talking about. Jesus calls it the glue that holds everything together, holds the whole universe, holds all together. A glue that holds all together. Makes it all possible. The light, the love, the light. And we need to see that light. But it's not seen with the body's eyes. It's not seen for the body's eyes. I remember when I had the vision of oneness, I saw everyone and everything in the universe, and it was like bathed in this light, kind of this, it seemed all light. But I wasn't seeing with my eyes, I was driving my truck. But somehow it was like interior sort of awareness of that. And it wasn't like a light was shining on them, it was like everything was light. Everything was made of light, is what I saw. We're all made of light. Everything is actually nothing but light, totally made of light. Not electromagnetic energy, but the true light, the living light. And so that light, yeah, everything, I give permission for everything to go off script right now. That's something the light can appreciate and responds to. And that's kind of the response that you can feel, is it's a wordless response. I call it like a wow, or yes, a wow. There's really no words that attach to it. Which is why I just could sit silently. Just let it be. Don't try to, try to attach concepts to it. Don't try to figure out what kind of concept can I attach to this. Like that. That's not necessary. Just let it be. Alright, so I went off script and drank a A&W root beer. But that's not what I'm talking about, going off script. That's just a little prop. So I can certainly feel this response, this sort of, or is that just fatigue? Maybe both. I don't know. Certainly, it's been a stressful week in the world. No question about it. We feel we're on the brink of a possible war, you know, World War III. It's very tense. The world's very tense. And who knows? Who knows what's around the next corner, actually, at this point? We could, if we wanted to, we could peek around the corner, but I'd rather even not at this point. You know, why get caught up in that? It's better to focus on how to truly be free of this entire absurdity of time and space and this mirage that we're working on. And we do that by, I give permission for everything to go off script right now. I extend the permission to everything without exception, as it is, to go off script right this instant. This right now. You release everything from the script. All scripts are released from all scripts. Everything, all of us, without exception, give permission for everything to go off script. Everything to go off script. The entire oneness to go off script. I tell you, we're going to need to go off script, right? Because the script that the world has is not a good one. It's hell-bent on succeeding at creating non-being. It's really hell-bent on it. So don't judge your brothers in spirit that are doing this. Don't judge them, because that will trap you in a script of judgment. Just give them permission, along with everything else, to go off script. And since you've given everything permission to go off script, you've also given yourself permission to go off script. See? In being, and to recognize being, going off script, allowing everything to go off script results in the recognition of being. And then you realize there's no need for the mirage at all. It's a non-necessity, and that's okay. You're okay with accepting that it's not necessary. And then none of it bothers you, won't bother you anymore. Won't be bothered by it. Okay. So, never know what the next, what's going to come next. It's like, wow. It just, the breakthroughs just keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. I don't know what's next. But the way things have been going every single day, it's just some tremendous step. And so you'll hear it right here on this YouTube channel, and who knows what's next as I have time, or you know, to something will arise for sure. Okay, very great. That's it.